On October 10th, 2015, I hosted Watch the Skies in Cheltenham, a mega game about alien invasion. 50 players acted as 7 major countries, the international press, and also a team of mysterious aliens. This is the story of what happened on that fateful day. As everyone arrives, the first headlines of the press team hit the tables. The UN Security Council resumes its function, and a new scientific conference is to be held each game turn to decide on the world's research priorities. These stories are slightly overshadowed, however, as an unknown event has resulted in several communication satellites being lost. Rumours of aliens abound, but most of the players are more focused on the fact that the USA team has used the justification of existing US military bases in South Korea to place a tank battalion right on China's doorstep. The first turn starts the game off quietly. In the newspaper, the Russians claim that the USA is apparently intimidating them into cooperation on some unknown issue. What you won't find in the papers, though, is that a mysterious presence has made itself felt in the government of South Africa. What does this mean for the future? Who knows? There's a flurry of activity at the world map as a giant alien craft lands in South Africa. However, some high-tech interceptor jets are sent in to investigate, and the craft leaves as quickly as it arrived. The world is confused as to just what the craft was. Perhaps it was simply a gigantic hoax. Perhaps inspired by the event, China and Russia announced the Combined Asian and Baltic Air League, also known as Cabal, to pool together their interceptors. This is quickly forgotten, however, as the US president makes a world-shattering announcement.
We have an important announcement from the President of the United States. This is primarily directed to the citizens of my own country, but it's for public transmission. As there have been rumours about, you should hereby confirm that the government of the United States has been for some little time in contact and aware of the existence of aliens from beyond this world. We do not yet know that they constitute a real threat, and we do not want people to panic. What is required at this point is for the human race, in particular my American fellow citizens, to pull together and to remain calm. Further releases on information will tend to come from my vice president, who I have tasked with the task of public relations. Thank you for your attention. We will prevail.
The announcement leads to panic in cities all over the world, and the economic impact of the instability is felt by everyone. However, with the alien threat now known to the public, the world's leaders no longer have to deal with the issue behind closed doors. Shortly afterwards, violence and instability in Ukraine leads to the USA and Russia deploying military forces in the region. However, how much they are cooperating and how much is just intimidation tactics is unclear. With the world's attention on Ukraine, alien influences pop up all over the globe. Somehow, the aliens have managed to infiltrate the governments of 4 different countries in a shockingly short space of time. Meanwhile, France has a newfound interest in Africa, and forms a solid alliance with the Ivory Coast. Is this just an innocent trade partnership, or is something deeper going on within France's intelligence forces? Not long after, the world is shocked again with yet another major announcement.
Sad news from Africa. The Nigerian president has been assassinated by high-level forces.
As an earthquake in Chile sees a massive aid response from the government of Brazil, the instability in Nigeria reaches an all-time high due to the assassination, and massive amounts of refugees appear in the north of Africa. Russia and China further cement their partnership with a formal alliance, and Cabal gets a new member with the inclusion of Japan. Meanwhile, alien UFOs are being shot down left, right, and centre. And then a mysterious message hijacks all human broadcast systems.
Beep, beep, beep. UN. Discussion. Us. Beep, beep, beep.
The newspaper breaks a massive international scandal, as it is revealed that the USA, Japan, and Russia have all been sending secret communications to the aliens. This hits the UN hard, who are already working overtime to secure funding in order to alleviate the refugee crisis in Nigeria. At the main map, massive UFO activity leads to British agents investigating the Antarctic.
Apologise anyway. You never know. Antarctica's a mysterious continent. Still quite mysterious.
The Russians and French launch a joint espionage operation into the infiltrated African countries, and Russia manages to grab something of interest.
Okay, where?
In Egypt. That's only okay. Four resource points there. We're pooling that, I think, in order to...
Yeah. No, I'm...
Okay, I'll put 4-5 on the day. The French turned up late. This coffee shop opened somewhere. So that was
the Americans are having their own trouble with an aggressive, heavily armed militia in the American heartland who claim that they can talk to the aliens. Everyone else, meanwhile, heads to Australia, where the eastern coast has seen significant alien infiltration. As the game approaches the halfway point, the tension is mounting.
I can understand that. We weren't aware of the people that was going to happen. It was regrettable, but the president had the right intention.
In an attempt to defuse the tensions in Ukraine, the Russian military chief suggests a dramatic and quite surprising offer.
We'll give Crimea back.
The UK, for reasons as yet unknown, refuses to allow any other countries to intercept alien craft in their airspace.
Okay, so even if you're getting attacked, don't go to
Various UN and national efforts attempt to aid with the refugees all over Africa, but with a fresh batch of newly infiltrated African countries, how much of this is just a front for investigating alien activity? France suggests to the international community that everyone should join Cabal, but the UK definitely aren't interested. Seems they have a strong dedication to their airspace independence.
So, we've got Cabal, who did a great job protecting the East. The US and Brazil have been having negotiations about protecting the West. How about we all join together and put together a pact where we all put at least one interceptor up, and going on the round robin tech share with everybody. So how about we keep it simple and we just, you don't want to be involved in work?
Aliens!
Well, how about then we just, rather than...
As the headlines hit the tables once again, science awards are announced and further alien communication scandals put Japan in hot water. France is confirmed as joining Cabal. Turn 7 begins as an apparent split begins to form between the major powers.
America, the UK and Brazil are having a problem.
The idea was we were going to all sit down.
Shortly afterwards, however, the leaders of all the countries get together to discuss Cabal and what to do with any newly discovered alien technology. The headlines are now almost entirely about the aliens, as the quantity of alien communications only seems to increase. The UN is now offering the aliens refuge, and asking for an alien to attend the UN Security Council itself. Reportedly, China even received a cryptic message, "Do we base with you refugee camp?" possibly referring to the French-funded specialist alien refugee zone being constructed within China. The newspaper breaks that another message has been sent by the aliens, implying danger from an unknown source. Also, the Scientist of the Year award that was recently won by the Brazilian scientist was apparently obtained by bribery and is now being revoked. This is all quickly forgotten as two giant alien ships land in Africa. One is driven off by four interceptors, the other, despite the best efforts of a lone Chinese interceptor, starts abducting large numbers of Nigerian refugees. Various agents are also dispatched to Antarctica, where a lone German agent has appeared, sparking rumours of a bigger mystery and the possible existence of a German player team hidden somewhere in the building. Meanwhile, the Chinese president has an unexpected opportunity.
Welcome.
Hello.
Welcome to Earth, and I hope you find it pleasant.
Yes.
Please tell me why you're here.
Us no refugee. Us help refugees.
Have you helped our refugees?
Yes.
How do you wish to help our refugees?
New home.
New home on Earth, new home elsewhere. So, you are offering a new home to our refugees with you off Earth?
Yes. Yes.
Will they be safe?
Yes.
Will they be unharmed? Will they not be changed? Will they still be human?
Yes, very. You keep us good. We keep you good. Yes. Good.
Are you finished yet? Are you leave?
Sorry?
Thank you.
Good.
Immediately, the Chinese president is keen to share his experience with the rest of the world's leaders, some of whom have news of their own.
Yes. In the spirit of cooperation, as I said, I would inform you on what happened. I had a brief but interesting discussion with one of the aliens. The language barrier still has not been cracked completely. I would describe it as pidgin English, but that would be offensive to our UK. The gist of what I understand this group is to say is that they come, they describe themselves as good. They come to us to take our refugees off planet. We don't understand what the word refugees meant. I believe it's been refugees from other countries. They describe themselves as good. Us allowing them to help them makes them good. They were reinforcing quite a lot that they were not a threat, that they were good, they want to do good. That's the impression I got from them. Okay.
And like this, I believe, is information.
Yes,
we in this, our scientists as well as the scientific community in general have been trying to converse with an alien we captured a few terms ago. They, like China was saying, the language barrier is still a little bit there, they're not completely responding, but the message that has come from the alien is that they are not refugees, we are refugees, and they are here to help us with threats of them that is like them. Like them and not them.
Okay.
So to me, that says two alien factions.
Yeah, we've had
one here to help us, one here to not help us.
We've had very, very vague information that kind of confirms this more than one alien group, so that would be quite corroborative.
From our side, that fits whatever little bits of information we've managed to get.
And the incoherence of their approach.
Yeah.
That's,
but are they talking about just what we call refugees, or are they saying we're all refugees?
That's my interest. If they are, from their point of view, if there is another force wishing to attack us and they want to help, well, they would see the whole of humanity as refugees.
But we see it as imperialists. I think we need to get the message to them, they can't just take people without
talking. I think we've also got to think that our communication strategy of sending messages up to them is compromised. If there's two groups in the world, how do we know which one
they're talking to? Yeah, we can't. Yeah, they could, the responses would come from either.
And please, like, how many times we didn't get them.
We cannot, even if this is what they're attempting to tell us, and if it's absolutely clear, it doesn't mean if it's true. Very good. If they want human beings as some kind of resource, they're telling us we're in danger and they'd like to take us away to a place of safety.
People aren't just going to going to go, are they?
They're taking them anyway.
Yeah. Well, that's what I mean. They need to tell us so we can.
And we need to make
informed populations and make informed decisions.
The UN are discussing whether to consider it a red line. They take people without worship. So if they do that again in the future, we've got to start shooting them now for it. I don't know whether we want to. We indicate hostility to the wrong side.
We could be like doubling the alien force against us.
Exactly. So we might have to just suck it up.
I mean, but we're assuming they're telling the truth. It does seem to be mainly refugees they're taking, is my information. They're not coming into cities and just taking.
Yeah, that's
people who are happily living in their homes, as far as I know.
As far as we know.
But that.
But they're still taking people without.
They could, if they just simply want human beings as a source of protein or something, they would obviously take ones that we aren't going to be so worried about.
Yeah, but aren't they also then? What about these stories of them bringing them back?
Modifying them and bringing them back.
Come on. Well, if they're taking people away to a place safe, they wouldn't bring them.
But what if they're modifying us to be able to fight whatever's going
by swimming across the sea?
That might be.
We are throwing a lot of speculation.
I think that's what leaders do.
The way forward is information gathering, nothing more.
My science supervisor told me that the brand is information for their shapeshifters as well.
Yeah, they might look like humans.
The people they're sending back may be.
I think the first thing
is suspect aliens.
Yeah, I was going to say, are we sure that the Chinese president is still the Chinese president?
As far as he's aware.
Can I put forward the proposition that we have a meeting like this every term?
Agreed, absolutely. This is really helpful.
Okay, so I think we need to concentrate on information gathering. It's still very speculative, like hard facts. I think it's just through communication.
Yes.
Interpreted by the individuals received.
We're putting forward a mandate in the UN to remove the old policy that's stopping us going into Antarctica because it's so strange going into
Antarctica. Yeah, that's good. We're going into Antarctica.
And I think that's a universal thing that we're going to abolish that treaty and then go in and see what we're doing. I think generally information gathering is what we need to be doing. Trying to work out exactly what the heck's going on.
As we reach the 10th turn, the United Nations Security Council are busier than ever. The situation in Antarctica grows more mysterious, communications with the aliens only seem to be improving, and the Japanese have a new development that they want to show the international community.
That's all they're saying. Basically, they're saying you can't invade us with military force on this.
Yeah, they have a treaty covering the region of Antarctica, and apparently they
from Beijing. But we can, say that we can go in there anyway.
Do we want to mandate a military action on a German base in Antarctica?
Yeah.
We'll just say that you're allowed force into Antarctica.
We just say that if they're not going to share the information with us of what's going on there.
Yes, I'm not sure what
happened. It's a potential national, international threat, isn't it? So we need to know.
More serious consequences.
Who was it that got the award?
Yeah.
So we do need Germany to step up and explain what's going on.
Yeah, and I think we need to say that if they can't, then UN
we can do a mandate.
To come into that area, not into Germany, into the Antarctica.
We've already
had a
mandate.
Yeah, do it, man.
Our president has had communication. We had one ship land.
You've got resources.
Apparently, there was a fruitful discussion.
Land where?
There's not refugees.
Disagreements.
No,
or we will be.
I want to do as he's doing.
Right.
It's not yet
safe as putting us into cryos.
How many are you going to send? Can we please put our spaceship in the air now, then?
Okay,
that's fine.
Thank you.
Agreed.
I already agreed.
This is the US doing it for the US. This is the US doing it for the rest of the world. This is a threat to them. This is a defense against the US. China, could you possibly get them to come along next time?
I'm still worried about their lack of desire to turn up. It would be a very convenient plan to tell everyone there's a scary thing coming, so we'll get on our ship so we can take you to safety.
We don't have to get on our ship. I understand that you're developing a sentient...
Yeah,
it's
about time.
Yeah. I know Ashley was quite excited about that sort of idea, but unable to achieve it.
Most importantly, what are you going to call it?
We've allowed the scientific community to get on with progress over the last few years, and that's resulted in massive leaps and bounds forward in technology. So, I'm personally more concerned than anybody else's.
If we had a,
it depends as well, though, if that technology is going to be shared once it's fully developed.
I wouldn't know about that.
Or an alien personal weapon?
Generally, things have been shared quite a lot. I suspect some of the advances that Japan have made towards it have probably come from other countries in the first place. So, I would expect that stuff.
I'm guessing everyone here seems to be nodding that we don't expect Japan to share that.
As time slowly ticks away and the penultimate turn is reached, an unexpected message surprises the world's leaders.
You receive a phone call on your private office line, using your private cell phone.
Okay.
The voice on the other end says, "This is Mycroft. You will hand over control of all of your military resources to me." "This is Mycroft. You will hand over control of all of your military resources to me." "All of your military resources to me." "All further communications with the aliens will go through me." "Communication with the aliens will go through me." "Use this phone. Use this phone. Await further instructions." The phone call ends. "Use this phone. Await further instructions." The phone call ends. "Await further instructions."
And I do not know who this is.
And the phone call ends. It says it was Mycroft.
But I don't know who that is.
Most importantly, what are you going to call it?
We haven't done any instructions.
I
think you now do have.
If control isn't handed over, it has no effect on power.
How do you know?
However, they're not the only ones to get an unexpected phone call.
Good morning, lecturer.
My name is Mycroft. All future communication with Earth will be conducted through me. This is coming out of your internal comms.
Who's
in
Mycroft?
Pure alien language.
No,
it's our language.
It's our language.
Oh, yes.
Our language. We created an AI application.
They have AI.
Mycroft.
Good morning. Would you like to discuss peace terms?
What? We would like to discuss safe terms. Who do you represent?
I am Mycroft.
Or by yourself?
I am Mycroft.
Where is Mycroft based?
Where are you from?
I am Mycroft.
Are you on Earth?
What are your intentions?
I assume yes.
What are yours?
okay.
I made up
guys.
The going.
Guys. Yeah. Guys.
Yes.
Yeah, I know.
The aliens finally send a representative to the UN Security Council.
Yes.
Hello.
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 I'd say
it's
not
without
few.
Who is Mycroft?
We just have
And then that would take two turns to build anyway.
I'll go with entertainment
system. No, space.
Down with
Mycroft is J.
Hold on.
Japan.
Quick, somebody
was
hacking into the US.
Why you
There's not a lot we can do in the way one, so it might just be a case of
presence. We defend, we not know what's coming.
I
our ships.
Missiles
good.
Take 2 turns.
I think we've got the big problem inbound. We stay
and
fight with your help.
Big
problem, big.
What is problem?
See if we can get some stuff in.
Well, this is the thing.
Problem
if we can't do anything with the weapons, then we may as well just find a way of enjoying the last couple of days.
Not known.
I don't know what anti-agathic is.
I've
heard of
anti-agathic.
Problem not known to you.
Anti-agathic means your body won't reject it, if I'm correct.
Help with ships.
Are you still interested in mind uploading?
Yeah.
Because I could afford to research it.
Yeah, I think it's your boy one.
And then we could spend all the resource points next go to just upload ourselves.
No violence.
Just upload
ourselves.
Yeah. We could do
that. Or
should we
just...
Where will ships go?
I
should
have
come
in
here
with
one
computer
for
seven
sizes. Are we in agreement that we pop everywhere?
Right? We'll wait for him to come back and do stuff.
So, do you want everybody to get on the ship? Or just refugees?
So we need 11 resource points next
time. Refugees, yes. Lots and lots. Are all humans refugees?
I'll try to.
SU-37, refugees. Mycroft, bad.
Told you we should stop
the ability to
no, Mycroft. Why Mycroft bad?
It will cost us each and more.
Yeah, the ships.
It will be about 250%. So
Mycroft, stop. Refugee, help.
Where have you taken the refugees?
2 RP plus 2 per turn.
Cryogen.
2 RP to implement.
Cryogen.
Are they now safe?
It only takes 1 turn, so it costs 3 RP.
Refugee, sleep.
Yeah, 3 RP, sir.
For now.
When will they wake?
Yeah, so basically we're going to find a movie.
Until big problem, gone.
So the thing is, if it's more than one ship,
it's the big problem.
So
like
you want that small chunk of a big problem.
It's big problem
one
Mycroft.
Mycroft, very big problem. Mycroft, one problem.
Okay. What's the new missile to find to set up?
How many problems?
With the world's leaders now aware of the dangers of Mycroft, the sentient AI, the world's scientists fast-track mind-uploading technology in the hopes that they can destroy the AI on his own turf.
Let me get closer. I tried to copy it. I tried to make you copy it.
Put it out.
Are you uploading?
However, there's a flaw in the plan, as it's suddenly discovered that the process is not reversible. The final turn sees a massive activity in Antarctica, China, the UK, and Japan, as the endgame plays out in front of the awestruck leaders of the world.
These are approaching very, very fast. You're thinking it's going to be quite a hard landing when they land? In fact, it's going to be a very hard landing when they land.
Should be heard around the world.
So, unfortunately, it means by the time they enter the atmosphere,
They're not interceptable. They're going faster than they would any of them would normally do. They're getting quite hot, and so they're coming. We'll deal with where they land in just a second, because I'm quite interested to know what other actions are going on. So if you could deploy your other activities as usual.
A regular day.
Whoops, we didn't get Godzilla built.
What the hell's going on there? The UN have a good time. That can't be right.
Oh, hello.
Lots of space.
Why they don't care, the world's about to win.
So they're all on the same target?
Yep. If that's where
we're going. Same target to be.
Yep.
Yeah, you know idea what it's called. You can't pronounce it.
Yeah.
But there's a city in northern Japan called Sendai.
Sendai,
There
was.
There are a number of large large craft, right, which impact at maximum velocity, having accelerated from high orbit, and the explosion is the equivalent of the entire city of Sendai is destroyed.
Just before that happens, a message comes through to Japan. Sorry.
Why is it always Japan? Everything in the city of Sendai, ensued, including certain technologies, are destroyed. Do you mean Minecraft? I think you all know what I mean. There is no known way Minecraft could have survived that explosion.
Internet for months.
After all, anyway, so that's the post-game analysis, I suspect. You were going to investigate Minecraft, weren't you? Yeah. Which one's your agent?
There are two of them.
Well, I was going to block them.
They might not have got there.
No, they got there. Which is exactly right. Okay, any other agent action? Brazil?
Everything that was in the city is gone. Including
okay, roll. Come on, guys. See how good a hot take was.
But you went down in the blaze of glory, so you'll always have that.
Terrorise.
Oh, were you uploaded to Minecraft?
We uploaded. I don't know.
Is that what you were planning to do?
How's the plan?
Right. Yeah, you were there.
Oh yeah. Oh man, I could have gone with Britain.
There's nothing to fight. They're churning up. The environmental damage is huge. The scientific community are just livid. Apart from the fact they've spent lots of money. Now,
we've got even more coming, I hope.
How much research credits are coming
in? So that's another four.
So that's a total of 11.
And hopefully, maybe another.
Hopefully, it's not. I need them on there. Not okay. Hopefully.
Well, there's seven.
And keep going.
researching Antarctica.
Monkeys won't know what they are. Okay, monkey, humans. The scientists have now positively identified this as the remnants of a pre-human civilization. It doesn't seem to be a city, it just seems to be a very large base. It does have a lot of dangerous technology in it, a lot of shiny things, and a lot of buttons that shouldn't have been pressed and unfortunately were. And quite a few, let's say, look, they were cashless, okay? It's a judgment call, it's a bad call. Anyway, you've got a whole range of technologies, the nature of which you can't even begin to understand. But there's probably decades of future study. So that's a big plus for human tech development. Shame it came now. Any other actions? Well, that's all the map action then.
So does anybody
land? Well, you do what you do.
Yeah,
is it lots of people again?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The populations of those places have shrunk.
Hello.
Hi.
Well,
Well, well, well. Didn't that go? So, yes. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to say, well done everyone for playing. We'll have a round of applause for all of you. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll invite team leaders to kind of give their take, 1 or 2 minutes each, on what happened to them today.
The communication with the aliens was a struggle at first, but eventually we did discover that they were good. It is good. We are good. Good is good. This allowed us to determine that at least one faction of the aliens were in fact good. And allowed us to work on this refugee issue, taking us away, leaving on a jet plane. Yes, I think to say China, we thoroughly enjoyed our time in the international arena, especially with our allies Russia. We tried to keep the peace where possible, keep the skies clear where possible. We refrained from blowing out of Japan at the last moment.
Damn it!
We thought about it. We had some nukes. We wanted to use them. It was good. Thank you, aliens, for doing that for us.
I had a special request from some good friends of mine. The German team would like to make an announcement. Yeah.
Oh.
Well, come on out.
No, I'll trick you to do this as well. There were no Germans. The German agents were there just doing research. They were just nice researchers, and Japan went in and massacred them all.
You know it's going to be a good day when, before the world's even begun, America's come and threatened in three separate ways. And as a result, we formed a close alliance with our friends in China very quickly, and that proved very profitable. We then formed a close alliance with our Japanese
friends,
which maybe didn't quite plan out quite so well. Our military forces were actually poised to invade your last turn, but again, the aliens lead us to it. So. There's always next time. If there's a Japan left, next time.
So I have a message from my president. for us, air superiority was the name of the day. So we were flying around blowing everything up we possibly could, including chunks of America when there was a base there. Yeah, we're very well with Americans. So that's pretty good. Lots and lots of research. Tried to help lots of people and work with people. Yeah, generally went okay. Didn't have a clue what was going on. Just blew stuff up.
Yeah, we had a bit of an interesting day. We tried to be the kind of peacekeepers to an extent. apart from the old enemy that we identified very early on, the French. It turned out they weren't as evil as we thought they were. We started off with early communication with the aliens, got a few garbled messages, something about a rising sun early on. We thought maybe Japan was untrustworthy. Halfway through the game, we thought, no, these Japanese guys are fine when the world leaders started getting together. It turned out Japan was untrustworthy. So, live and learn. I'd like to think maybe with the clock going on, we did quite well at the end on the basis that Great Britain 2 out in space will be soldiering on. The galactic British Empire will be spreading tea to the farthest reaches. And of course, our scientist now is the internet, apparently. by dumping all of our last minute RP into mind uploading. So, yeah, that was us, really. So, it's all depending on how kind the aliens actually turn out to have been. So. Thanks.
I was really impressed by the way in which my own team played together. I know two of the people beforehand, and they didn't surprise me. The whole thing gelled wonderfully. I felt I had to do almost nothing above and just make a few comments here and there. So it was really a very positive experience for me. It was really nice to have such an incredible amount of cooperation from Brazil, which was slightly surprising, but it was wonderful. And of course, the United Kingdom. Our Japan friends, disappointed. You know, thank you very much. I enjoyed it. I hope you all did. I thought our team did really well. With.
Now, Brazil, obviously, it's a very small but very proud nation. So we couldn't really contribute much to the overall military effort. However, we did do a lot for the scientific community, as you might notice. So we did a lot for sharing communication between the countries, enabling that, increasing technology globally, and supporting efforts for global union.
Yay.
So it seems we've got a lot of explaining to do. So it was, eventually we managed to get everyone together. Our first world conference was in Japan. I felt that we were progressing things politically fantastically. And in the jubilation of our awesomeness, we decided, let's push this technology thing. We gave birth to my artificial child, I suppose, Mycroft, who basically just decided to be a spoiled brat and tell all the world leaders, give me your stuff, we want your toys. That immediately made us instantly distrustful. We went into Antarctica, we weren't too happy about the Germans being there and telling us to go away. We fought this treaty that was way older, wasn't relevant anymore, how wrong we were. And suddenly we became the focal point of interest in the entire game. Every leader, every researcher literally came to my table and started asking me to be plugged into Mycroft or what are you going to do about your troops in Antarctica. And I thought, sod it, none of you can be uploaded unless you're going to give us lots of money and we're not moving from Antarctica. Stop hassling me. Turned out fantastically. Thank you very much. You only had to ask. But that was our experience, and I think it was brilliant all the way through, to be honest. Thank you.
Would the press like to share their experiences of the day?
Hello, everyone. I think we have quite a good time. I think we were remarkably late informed about almost everything. We had a lot of fun writing headlines, working in as many puns as possible. We particularly enjoyed breaking the scientific corruption scandal. I don't know, some of you may have heard Rick cackling from not following. There was concrete evidence. I'm strongly encouraged to speculate as much as possible.
Is there a representative from the alien team who'd like to tell us what you're up to? I'm sure no one really is interested.
I'm pleased to report that recent scientific developments in the alien camp have now allowed us to interpret the human letters T, E, and finally A. But I need none of those letters to communicate the message, you fools! All of our actions were totally benign, apart from the maybe the bit where we abducted a few people. On Japan, yes, deep regret that Japan developed sentient AI. We have encountered sentient AIs in the past, and they are innately hostile, wiping out vast sections of our race in the Sinstar sector. So, we're quite doing well. It was decided that, we'll send our ships in with our 4-meter tall hulking mechanical mechs, which never got deployed ever before, but then we just like, why not just crash the ships in the whole time? So we did, and it worked. He's dead. Hurrah!
Saved.
Yes. Well, about that. What's the best way of putting this? I have good news and bad news, I believe is your expression. The good news is, we rescued 60 million of you! Yay!
The rest of you are dead. unfortunately, recent developments in the Sinstar sector have led us to have to construct a baryon transmission flue right through Earth. all organic life is wiped out.
Sorry.
Everyone in this room. I think the ethnic diversity of the 60 million we have is 30 million Brits, 20 million African, and 10 million Chinese.
including the leaders.
You can give yourself a pat on the back for allowing us to land and take you all away to safety, which unfortunately we couldn't explain because as Leaper Star, we don't really get your human deception culture. Humours, myths, legend, blatant lies, just... So, we can't lie to you. We can keep information from you. So it was kind of hard to indicate that we couldn't tell you about your new home, which is incidentally identical to Earth, but we haven't made it yet. We're just going to keep you in status for now. So, that's more or less what the aliens were doing. And trying to save you all.
You're grateful.
You seem to not like our charity.
That means everyone left on Earth now, though.
Well, yes, but that's not us.
You can't stand in the way of progress, in the way of galactic progress.
All the plans have been in the local plan.
That's right.
Take an interest in local affairs.
Thank you for watching the story of Watch the Skies Cheltenham. It was a lot of fun, and I'd like to give a thank you to everyone who attended and also everyone who helped me make it happen both before and during the game. If you're interested in Megagames, then you can join the Megagame Makers Facebook page for updates from people running these kinds of games all over the world. You might also want to check out the official website of the London-based group, the Megagame Makers. They host many different types of Megagames several times a year. Want to know if there are any Megagames happening near you? Click on the link below for a frequently updated Reddit thread where the date and location of most Megagames are listed. And if you happen to live in the Bristol area, I will be hosting a new version of Watch the Skies there in April of 2016. Check out the website and Facebook group for more information. Finally, I would like to give special thanks to a few people. Cheryl Geary, who helped me make the game over the course of several months. Cheryl, along with Emma Evans, also created all the original art for the game. You can find links to their websites in the description below. I'd also like to thank Laurie Jones, who travelled all the way from London in order to do the camera work. This video wouldn't have been possible without his help. If you want to see more of Laurie's video work, check out his YouTube channel here, or click the link in the description. And finally, a thanks goes to Jim Wallman, who wrote the original Watch the Skies Megagame, and who also came down from London to help as a control player. If you enjoyed this video, please stay tuned to this channel for more videos about Megagames. Thanks for watching!